Yeah, hello. Am I audible to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Okay, we'll continue with the next topic, lymphatic and immune system. What actually the lymph is? When the blood is carried by the blood vessels to the organ or to the tissue, there only the cells part will come back to the veins. The liquid part, the plasma part, will go into the tissues. So that will stay in the tissues only. When the plasma present in the blood, we call it as plasma. When the liquid part present in the blood, we call it as plasma. When it goes to the tissues, we call it as tissue fluid. So this tissue fluid is actually drained by a separate system. And that separate system, we call it as lymphatic system. That system will have lymphocytes that will fight against the infections also. And that will check whether the fluid is having any bacteria, virus, and in that will cleanse the fluid also. So that system we call it as lymphatic system. So we have the lymphatic system in the digestive system also. So there the lymphatic system helps to absorb the fat. And coming to the functions of immune system, that actually will fight the diseases and infections. So coming to the organs of the lymphatic system, we have the lymph nodes, lymphatic vessels, thymus gland, spleen, and tonsils. So in this picture, you can able to locate it. So we have these, the lymphatic thymus. So this is lymphatic tissue. What is lymphatic tissue is whatever the tissue which fight against the infections, which has the lymphocytes, we call that as lymphatic tissue. That's it. So those type of tissues are thymus, which is present in front of the heart, in the chest region, and tonsils, which is present in the neck region and throat, and the spleen. So spleen is also a lymphatic tissue. We call this as graveyard of RBC because the RBC will die in the spleen. And these are the lymphatic nodes. We have thousands of nodes all over the body. These actually are the checkpoints. And from the to the lymphatic nodes, we have the lymphatic vessels. When the blood is fluid, we should not call it as blood, we should call it as lymph. So when the lymph is flowing into these vessels, so in between we have this lymphatic nodes, which is like a checkpoints that usually will check the fluid, whether it is having any bacteria, virus, or any pathogens. Inside this lymphatic nodes, we have lymphocytes that actually will capture the bacteria, will eat it like phagocytosis. We call it as phagocytosis, eating any pathogens. So that's how it will, if we call it as army system of our body, that actually is the defense mechanism. And coming to the combining forms, adenoids. So adenoid means lymphatic tissue. Immuno, which means protection. Lympho means lymph. Lymphadeno, which means lymph node. Lymph angio. Angio means vessel. So lymph angio means lymphatic vessel. Patho means disease. Spleno is spleen. Thymo, which means thymus. Tonsillo, which is tonsils. Toxo means poison. So toxic means poison. Coming to the suffix, globulin, which means protein. Coming to the network, we already have seen lymphatic vessels, lymph nodes, spleen, thymus, tonsil. These are all together, we call it as lymphatic organs. And the lymphatic tissues are spleen, lymph node, thymus, and tonsils. So first thing, in this picture, this is the heart. Heart actually will pump the oxygenated blood through the artery to the tissues. What happens here is only the blood cells, RBC, WBC, platelets, will come back through this venous system, and that will be flowing. The fluid content will be there in the tissues itself. That actually we call the fluid inside this as tissue fluid. It actually will be drained by this separate system. We call this as lymphatic system. This green color is the lymphatic system that will drain the lymphatic fluid and give it back to the veins. And finally, it is taken over the cells and the lymphatic fluid together again as blood will go to the heart. So this is actually the anatomy and physiology part of lymphatic system. Do you got this? How it goes? So that's why prior to the lymphatic system, we have to know about the blood. And second, the lymphatic vessels are very small in the intestine. It was there in the intestine also. That is actually for the fat absorption. And finally, the fat will be delivered to the circulatory system. So these lymphatic vessels, we call that as lacteals. Lacteals are the lymphatic vessels present in the digestive system. And the third most, we have the lymphatic system will work together along with the immune system. Because, so we have the group of, that has the primary, so lymphocytes, which actually will kill the bacteria, virus or pathogens. So this is the lymphatic vessel. We have a big network of lymphatic vessels throughout our body, which is one way. There is no two-way passage of fluid. Always the fluid will go in one direction only. And we have here, we call it as walls. Walls are present in the lymphatic vessels. So why do we have a wall? This to prevent the backward flow of the blood. That's why we have the walls here. So this is the real picture of the lymphatic vessel. This is the wall. And lymphatic vessels are actually the smaller capillaries, means very, very smaller blood vessels that actually will merge into larger lymphatic vessels that will drain into a lymphatic duct into the thoracic cavity. Finally, all the lymphatic vessels will combine to form a bigger tube. That bigger tube will drain into the inferior vena cava. So these are the smaller network of lymphatic vessels that finally will drain into this inferior vena cava. By here it will drain. And we have the lymphatic nodes also. So we have a group of nodes. We call that group of nodes as, if it is present nearby the neck, we call it as cervical nodes. If it is present nearby the heart, we call it as mediastinal nodes. If it is present nearby the armpit, then we call it as axillary nodes. So this is the lymph node. We also call it as lymph gland. Inside this lymph nodes, we have the lymphocytes, which actually will kill the bacteria, virus or any pathogen. So these are the lymphatic vessels that will be entering into the lymphatic node. And these are the lymphatic vessels that will be exiting out of the lymphatic node. This is the location of lymphocytes and antibodies will be present here. And this, this is the lymphatic vessel entering and this is the lymphatic vessel will be leaving. The fluid will come from this direction and this will check whether the fluid is having any bacteria or not. And that will let the fluid to go outside. And the lymphatic nodes with the houses, the lymphocytes and antibodies, that actually will remove the pathogens and cell debris. And it also traps the cells and also the cancer cells also. So the lymphatic nodes are present in the axillary, cervical, inguinal, mediastinal. Cervical, axillary is armpits. Cervical is neck. And inguinal is groin. Mediastinal is chest. And tonsils. So tonsil is also the lymphatic tissue. Located inside the throat. We have three sets of tonsils. Palatine tonsils present on the palatine region. Pharyngeal tonsils present on the pharynx. Lingual tonsils present on the tongue. The tonsils are also will have the WBC. That actually will kill the pathogens that are entering into the digestive system and respiratory tract. So if the tonsils are removed, that is also safe. So there is no any, that is not required for life. For living, we don't need tonsils. So sometimes if any infection is there, they will remove the tonsils very easily. And spleen. So spleen was located in the left upper quadrant of the abdomen. LUQ means left upper quadrant. So it is also a lymphatic tissue, which consists of leukocytes. So which inside this, it has the blood sinuses and spaces. So the blood will be flowing very slow into the spleen because of the spaces. So spleen also will have phagocytic macrophages that will be actually lining the blood sinuses to remove the pathogens. So the blood will be moving very slowly and it gives time to identify the pathogens and to take off the RBC also. And it will filter and destroy the old RBC and recycles the iron. which is, this is also a not essential organ. If the spleen is also removed, there is no much damage to the body. Thymus. So thymus was located in the upper portion of the mediastinum. It produces the hormone called thymosin. It actually will change the lymphocytes to T lymphocytes. So the activation of lymphocytes will take place. And also, so it is very active and very bigger in the unborn child. When we are getting towards the puberty, this actually will shrink and degenerate. By now, we don't have the thymus gland. And that is also essential for the proper development of the immune system, because it is the major thing where the T lymphocytes will get developed. So it is a very key role in the immune system. So immunity. So immunity means body's defense mechanism. So body's defense mechanism is two types. One is natural immunity. Other one is acquired immunity. So first one is, we'll go with natural immunity. We also call it as innate immunity, which being there from our birth itself. So it doesn't require any exposure to the pathogen. So we have the naturally, we have the WBC, WBC, eosinophils, basophils, neutrophils, lymphocytes, all these things. This we call it as natural immunity. And acquired immunity is body responds to the specific antigen. For example, we have two types of acquired immunity. One is passive and the other one is active. First one is passive. Passive is actually when the person receives the protective substance from another person. For example, in the mother milk, we have the antibodies. So taking the antibodies from the mother, we call it as passive acquired immunity. Active acquired immunity is when we get a disease, we will get immunized. Means our body will learn how to fight against that bacteria. That we call it as active. In that also, the immunization, taking vaccination is a type of actively acquired immunity. So the disease-causing agents, we call it as antigens. So bacteria, virus, pathogens, we call those as antigens. In the antigens also, there are two types of immunity. One is humoral immunity and the other one is cellular immunity. Humoral immunity is present in the blood. Cellular immunity is present in the tissues. Humoral immunity is mediated by B lymphocytes, means bone marrow lymphocytes. Cell-mediated immunity is maintained by T lymphocytes. We call it as thymus-activated lymphocytes. And so the same thing what I told you. Whatever the thing, it targets the pathogen and it will kill it by phagocytosis. And it prevents the infectious agents by damaging the healthy cells. Cellular immunity is very natural killer cells. Because of T cells, we call this as cytotoxic. So that will attack and destroy the pathogens. Coming to the precautions. So we have large number of pathogens in the hospital settings. So we have different types of infections. One is nosocomial infections. When we go to the hospital, we get this infection. Then we call it as nosocomial. Cross-infection, the pathogen acquired from another person. Actually, COVID-19 is a cross-infection. Or a cold, cough, or any other fever. Viral infections are actually cross-infections. Reinfections. Once we got infected with some disease, again we are getting the same thing. Then we call it as reinfection. Self-inoculation. So we got the disease to one part. And the same disease we get to the another part of the body. Then we call it a self-inoculation. These are the precautions like washing hands, wearing mask and sanitizing our hands. And next, we have to put the protective mask. And also we should not expose any mucus related parts like nose, mouth, ears, all those stuff. These are the safety precautions. And we should not contact the infected person. We have to keep them in an isolation for our safety purpose. And we have to not to go in the crowded areas. Whatever we are following in this stage, all these precautions are there. So coming to the word building part. Adenoidectomy, surgical removal of the adenoids. Adenoiditis, inflammation of the adenoids. Adenoids means lymphatic tissue. Immunologist, immunity specialist. Lymphadenectomy, surgical removal of lymphatic gland. Lymphadenopathy, lymph gland disease. Lymph angiogram, record of lymph vessels. lymphangioma, lymph vessel tumor. Lymphoma, which is lymphatic tumor. Lymphatic, pertaining to the lymph. Pathogenic, means disease producing. Pathology, study of diseases. Splenectomy, surgical removal of spleen. Splenomegaly, enlarged spleen. Thymectomy, surgical removal of the thymus. Thymoma, thymus tumor. Tonsillar, pertaining or related to the tonsils. And tonsillectomy, surgical removal of tonsils. Tonsillitis, inflammation of the tonsils. So, coming to the vocabulary. Okay, till here it is enough. Tomorrow we'll continue with the remaining part because it was the huge thing. Till here it will be crispy and clean. Okay? Hello?
Yes. Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Tomorrow we'll continue. We'll complete the remaining short part of this topic, and we'll start with cardiovascular system. Whoever are pending with cardiovascular system, you can continue tomorrow's class.
Okay.
If I'll share you the PPT. If you are having any doubts regarding this topic, please text me. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye.